In this problem, you need to divide your work up into chunks, in this case tiles. We have a continuum between tiny tiles, lots of them, and fewer tiles, where each tile is sized to the maximum that can fit in a single thread block. And in this particular problem, bigger tiles means less memory bandwidth. This is good. Generally then, you want to make your tiles as big as can fit into a single thread block, because that minimizes overall memory bandwidth. But note the following two caveats. One, you need to have at least as many thread blocks as you have SMs in your GPU, because otherwise you'll have SMs sitting idle. Definitely you want to make sure you fill the machine with enough work to keep all the SMs busy, even if you have to move a little bit this way on the continuum and size your tiles just a little bit smaller. Two, if you're sitting at the right end of this continuum, it's best for overall memory bandwidth. But often it turns out that you'd actually prefer to move just maybe one tick to the left. This allows a small number, say two blocks, to both be resident at a time. And that potentially gives better latency hiding characteristics because you have more warps that may be in flight at the same time from slightly different pieces of the program. It's certainly something that you would want to tune carefully if you needed the very fastest possible implementation.